Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today we will talk about how to compile Go programs for multiple operating systems. So let's get started. When we want to compile Go programs, we are using go build command. We already saw how to use it in my previous videos, but let's make a recap here. The command is go build with optional arguments like -o for output, or build flags or packages. When we build main package, the compiled program name will be the same as the first source file. Go build hello.go, compiled program name is hello or hello.exe. Now, if we want to name our compiled program differently, we would use -o flag. Let's say that we want to call our program greetings instead of hello. We would execute this command. On Windows, go build-o greetings.exe hello.go. On macOS and Linux, just omit .exe suffix, so it will be go build-o greetings hello.go. This will create an executable file named greetings or greetings.exe. Go give us possibility to build programs for multiple platforms, Windows, Linux, macOS, Solaris, and more, without using that platform. For example, I can build Linux and macOS executable files on my Windows machine. To build a program for some platform, we need to know two things. First, operating system, and second, processor architecture. To find out those two values for our current running platform, we can use go env command. This command will help us to examine the values of go environment variables. When we run this command, we will see a big list of environment variables. We are just interested in two of them. One is GOOS, which stands for Go operating system, and the other one is GOARCH and stands for Go architecture. I just want to mention that GOOS and GOARCH variables default to the values of GoHost OS and GoHost Arch respectively. The values of GoHost OS and GoHost Arch will be automatically determined by our host OS and architecture. To just see values for those two variables, we can run this command go env GOOS GOARCH. And we will see those values. On this example, we can see that GOOS is equal to Windows, so I'm running Windows OS, and GOARCH is equal IMD64, is a generic name for x86-64-bit architecture. To see all possible platform architecture combinations that Go can build programs for, we can use Go tool command for that. Command is go tool dist list. This will output a list of currently supported platforms and architectures for installed Go version on your machine. This list may change with future versions of Go. In this list, we can see that output is formatted like goose/gorge combination. So first value is operating system and second is processor architecture. Now that we know our current GOOS and GOARCH values and all possible ones, let's see how we can use them to build Go programs for different platforms. In this table, we can see GOOS and GOARCH values for three main operating systems: Windows, Linux, and macOS. macOS is based on Darwin operating system, so value for GOOS is Darwin. Here we can see commands we will use to build our programs for mentioned operating systems. Example file that we will use to compile is Hello World. You can find link to the code in description. Navigate to your code directory in your terminal. To compile program for Windows, we will run go build command with next options. GOOS equals Windows, GOARCH equals IMD64, go build-o hello-win.exe hello.go. Also, because I am on Windows machine and my default values for GOOS and GOARCH are same as one specified in command, we can omit them. And in that case, Go would use GoHost OS and GoHost Arch values to build a program. We can see that now in our project directory we have new hello-win.exe file. Next, let's compile same program for Linux with Intel 80386 microprocessor. Command is goose equals linux, gorch equals 386, go build-o hello-linux hello.go. Same here. We can see that new file hello-linux was built. And now to compile program for macOS with Apple Silicon, which uses ARM64 architecture, we will execute this command. Goos equals Darwin, gorch equals ARM64, go build-o hello-mac hello.go. Once again, we can see hello-mac file inside our directory. If you are on Linux or macOS, you can use the file command to get more information about files that we just created. To use it, type file, then name of the file you want to examine. Here, we can see the outputs of our built files. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please press like button, and if you would like to see more content like this, you can subscribe to my channel. For the text version of this material, check link to my blog post in description below. Until the next time, bye!